Alright guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new, my name is Bobby. Guys, let's talk about the Macedonia question. After publishing those infamous three videos, many of my own countrymen contacted me and asked certain questions. Alright, let's be honest, 90% of those mails were death threats, hate mails, and people telling me to fuck my mother. Epa fala, bratia, thank you very much. That was to be expected. However, before I start this video, I want to clarify. Guys, I love Macedonia. I love my own country. This message doesn't come from hate, but from the heart. I love my fellow people. I love my land. Obviously. But you know what I love more than my own land, more than my own family? That is the truth. I love the truth and I cannot help it. This is why this channel is about seeking truth. I said it before, the truth shall set you free. It is the most valuable thing we got as humans. We try to find objective truth, and therefore, when we talk about the Macedonian question, when we talk about the country as such, many of you were concerned and said, you want to sell us out. You want to sell us to the Bulgarians. You want to sell us to the Greeks. Guys, I don't want to do anything and I can't do anything. I am one person. In the end, it boils down to the people. At least this would apply if we have a true democracy. Of course, we are all victims of corruption, politically, unfortunately. Especially on the Balkans, we've seen our fair share of that. However, about the country, Macedonia. Nobody can take away your country. Legally, since the 40s, it is its own country. Obviously, that is undoubtedly so. Please understand this. Macedonians reached out to me and told me it is our basic human right to have our own country. Duh, of course, that is absolutely correct. Let's think about the Australians. Who are the Australians? Of course, originally, they would be the Aborigines. But who are the modern day Australians? The modern day Australians, genetically, their ancestors, around about 400 years ago, are of course Englishmen. They call them Pommies for a reason, prisoners of Main Island. Back in the day, Australia has been built through prisoners of the Main Island of England. Australia is still under Commonwealth, and Australia, just a couple of years ago, used pounds as a currency. So it is as English as it could be. However, again, we respect the basic human rights. It is obviously its own country. The same applies to New Zealand. So now, no New Zealander, no Australian wants to be called an Englishman. I get that. We understand that. We respect that. No worries. However, if I open up the history book, I will see, hey, Englishmen built that country. The basis of that country is, of course, English. Let's talk about France now. Who built France? The Franks. Die Franken. Who are die Franken? The Germans. Germans. Charlemagne. Charles. Karl Alemannia. Alemannia, Alemannia, Germania, Germany. There you have it. So, Charlemagne was a German from a German tribe who built up France. Now, is France its own country? Undoubtedly so. Of course it is. It has its own culture, croissant de beurre, and the beautiful wine. Of course it does. However, when we look into the history books, we will see the truth. We will see it is based on Germany. all good. Doesn't change the fact that they are now French. Fair enough. In this day and age, we can identify as anything, basically. We see women identifying as men. We see men identifying as women. And that is all right. Do your thing if you have to. However, if I choose to look into a biology book, what will I find? X, Y, chromosomes. I will see what defines a male, and I will see what defines a female. I will understand that as objective as I can as a human being, and then I will go from there. Now, if I go to Thailand and there is a ladyboy and he, she wants to be addressed as she, all right, no worries. I say she to the trans woman. It's not a woman. It's not a man. It's something totally different. I do understand that this man clearly doesn't want to be a man after doing 7 surgeries, putting in plastic breasts and cutting off their genitalia. I got the memo. I understand. You don't want to be a dude. I'm not going to call you a dude. You went through everything not to be a dude. I get it. However, if I look into the biology book, I want truths. I want to understand what the reality of this nature is. So now, again, let's talk about the Macedonian question. And if you're new to this channel, I know I rant, I shout, I have a way about me that this could be misinterpreted. However, I want to remind you, I'm coming from love. I love my brothers and sisters. My whole family is in Macedonia. Cousins, uncles, aunts, everybody. Everybody is still there. Making those videos, I get into trouble that I don't have to involve myself in. But why do I do it? I do it because I love the truth, yet again. So now, when we talk about the history, again, all the links are in the description box below. You can do your own research. Don't take my research for granted. I am not saying that there is no propaganda on the Bulgarian side. I'm not saying that there is no propaganda on the Greek side. Ladies and gentlemen, this is 2020. We have inside jobs, false flags everywhere. Governments are corrupt. Governments wrecked us plenty of times. This is nothing new. There are elitists in this world that want to control every aspect of human life. Of course, there is propaganda on every single site. That is what it is. Nobody is innocent. We are all equally guilty. However, we do have material such as the Encyclopedia Britannica, where we can research what has happened in the past 700 years. There are documents, Ottoman records, etc., etc. I talked about it. So now, to sum this up, what do I want? I want the Macedonian people to see the truth. I want the Macedonian people to see what their history truly was like. Not a romanticized version of Tito. Not a falsified version of the communists. No matter if Macedonian, Serbian, Bulgarian, or Greek, communists are all the same criminals. This is the truth. And we do not want to base our existence on a false reality, which isn't even a reality, but some sort of parallel universe that we invented or that has been fed to us. We want the truth, brothers and sisters. I hope you want it too. I hope you want to pursue truth and not be right for the sake of being right. This is not about winning an argument. This is about understanding our roots. This is about reclaiming our heritage. This is about understanding who we truly are. Don't you understand? He who controls the past controls the future. Our whole future has been defined by communists. We've been misled, we've been brainwashed. This is a message from the heart. When I see young people in Macedonia, I see nothing but hate. no matter who I involve myself with in discussion, all I'm getting is death threats and insults. And I'm not the only one. I'm not a special snowflake. I talk to many people, no matter if they are from Macedonia or Bulgaria or Greece. It is just a big show. Just fighting over and over again, insulting. Why don't you step out of your own comfort? Just see it as objectively as you can. Try to understand the other side. Can it truly be that we are the only one who got it right? If you have an argument with a person, shouldn't you listen to the other person to understand their worldview? I know this is very hard for us on the Balkans. We have this huge temper, this huge ego. We want to be right no matter what we do. I lived on the Balkan. I know how it is. We are right always. But see, the Bulgarians think they are right. The Greeks think they are right. The Macedonians think they are right. There is an objective truth. If I say this is a water bottle and you say it's a Coca-Cola, somebody is right. Somebody has the truth. It's not that we can agree then and say, you know what, we are both right. No, one happens to hold the truth. And sometimes it is not us. It happens. I'm not saying that Macedonia is lying about everything. But there are certain facts that we should embrace and we should try to understand. We shouldn't sit there being ignorant, arrogant, and just acting as we know it all. Why is the opposition wrong? Then try at least to debunk it. So guys, on that note, again, all the links are in the description box under this video. You can click on it and go through the links. Books, articles, historical records. Try to debunk me. Wouldn't that be the smartest choice? If you really believe I'm full of shit, rightfully so, no worries. But then please try to do your own research. Just go through the links and debunk me in the comment section. No worries. Take this video, share it with everybody. Share it with knowledgeable people. Share it with historians, if you will. Share it with people so we can have a discussion. Listen, this is not a message of war. I think you would all agree that we had enough wars on the Balkans. Man, do you think that I want to see further separation? This is a message of unity. All I wanted is for the people to understand that we have common ancestors, that we are one people, that we are brothers and sisters, that we, especially as Christian Orthodox, should embrace each other, should celebrate our union. Isn't it funny? Isn't it comical that when the EU comes about, everybody wants to unite? No worries. Everybody wants to be in the EU. But when we as people, as Christians, if you will, as Balkan brothers and sisters, why can't we make it happen? Why can't we unite? Why can't we bring ourselves together through love and not through hate? I still don't see you understanding my message. It is about love. It is about unity. It is about coming together as brothers and sisters and not to see a whole generation being brought up with more hate. Have you seen the comment section? Have you seen the comment section under other videos? In chats? Tartars, Tartars, gay reeks. What is wrong with you? Where's this hate coming from? So many people, as I said, they're flagging my videos. For what exactly? If you disagree, open your mouth like a man, talk. No worries, use your brain. Why are you so insulting? It shows a huge insecurity. If you would be so secure about your national identity, you wouldn't have to insult people on the internet. I wish everybody nothing but the best. The Greeks, the Bulgarians, the Serbians, they told me, hey, you never mention us. Of course, man. The Serbians, the Croats, the Albanians, the Macedonians, everybody. I love all people. Some of you make it very, very hard to love you. However, I'm still trying. As a Christian Orthodox, our mission is to love all people, to not look at skin color, at nationality, but to love and embrace all people. This is what we're trying to do. But of course, there is a threat on this earth. We say it comes from the devil. What is this separation? What is this hate that is in your hearts? You have to open up your hearts in order to listen to the other side. So now, let's sum this up. This video is about you. It is about you making your own research. It is about you debunking me, about spreading the truth, about collectively understanding the truth. So we have a global consensus. Knowledge is power. Without knowledge, all we are left with is slurs, random screams and shouts like animals. We as humans are in the position where we can educate ourselves, especially now in 2020 with the internet. We can do our own research. We can find the objective truth. And this should be our pursuit as people. In the end, it does not matter who holds the truth right now. It is about finding out what the truth is. All right, guys. And this is it for today's rant. It is longer than expected. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you made it all the way through. If so, leave it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed already, guys, please do so. Make sure to share this video so people understand this message. I don't want to see people randomly stumbling across my first video and not understanding what this message is. This is a very important message for those that want to hear, for those that want to understand. For those that are blind, they won't understand. It doesn't matter what you present them with. All right, but this is it for today. As always, may God bless you all. Much love and peace. Благословенне си, Господи, научи мя оправданием Твоим ангельским.